may be addressed in writing to the manager,
Aaron. Good morning, Wairarapa. Rob Maunsell here with another edition of Move, Mingle and Play. And I have a special guest with me today, Dr. Helen Clayson. And we're going to talk about Paddock Day at Gladstone, which comes up on Sunday. Good morning, Helen.
Morena.
As an introduction to Helen, she's been in the Wairarapa for a few years, but she is English. And in honour of her heritage, I'm going to play you a song by Celtic women. How about that, Helen? Fields of Gold, written by Sting, performed by the Celtic women and their fabulous orchestra. So, the fields of Gladstone, are they covered in gold?
I'm not so sure about that, Rob, but we're hoping that our field that becomes Paddock Day on Sunday will be a field of fun for the community,
yes,
by the community.
Yeah, and this is the first one, isn't it?
First one ever.
New initiative.
Yes, set up by the Gladstone Project Group, which started about 18 months, 2 years ago. A group of people who either have businesses or all who live in Gladstone, interested in promoting Gladstone as a destination. So with a view to really the sort of opportunities in Gladstone originally, and then its vision extended into really looking at social cohesion and connectivity, developing social resilience, all of which have become more important during the times of COVID, of course.
Yeah.
So our first event is this Sunday, 11 till 3. It's called Paddock Day. Can I show you the poster?
Yeah, please. Well, in fact, you haven't come on screen yet. Maybe you need to do a little bit. G'day, you guys.
you can do that.
The cameras haven't picked you up yet. Anyway, okay. we'll do the poster when I know you're on screen.
So Paddock Day is a combination of a country fair with entertainments and a market. And so we invited local people to take stalls. And we've been amazed by the response. We've got 47 stalls booked for this first event, which we are thrilled about.
Wow, that's
huge.
And
if I refer to my notes, I can tell you what sort of things we're going to have. I mean, there are one or two tractors, a horse-drawn gig or two. We've got stalls selling tools, furniture, some of it upcycled.
Yeah.
Plants, I've been potting up furiously. Lampshades. A bicycle, books, games. There are people from local wineries there. Candles, muesli, household goods. Yeah. People have been encouraged to see it a bit like the old barn sales where the farmers cleared out their barns.
Yeah.
And in these days of decluttering, there's going to be a lot of household stuff, I think.
Yeah.
There's going to be something for all ages, pony rides for the children and face painting. There's going to be a gypsy cob horse that the children can pat. Going to be quite a lot of food. We've got the Wairarapa event fuel people doing burgers and real fruit and Danish ice creams. Hot dogs. We've got the Gladstone School providing burgers, I think venison burgers and a sausage sizzle.
Yeah.
And the Lions food truck doing hot chips.
Yeah.
The Gladstone Rugby Club is organising a bar.
So you don't have to bring a picnic lunch.
You don't have to, but you're welcome to. There's going to be plenty of straw bale seating, I think.
Yeah.
And music's going to be provided by Dragonfly, the Wycall band.
Oh, they're cool.
Which is going to be great.
They rock.
Absolutely.
You have to be careful with their volume, though. Who's doing their sound?
I'm not sure. Not me. and there's going to be games for the kids as well.
Yeah.
So we're hoping it's going to be a real family event, provided for the community by local people.
Yeah.
And there's going to be two of us doing a bit of a survey of what people in Gladstone think about living in Gladstone and also what they might want to contribute to their local community. So often we're asked, what do you want? What haven't you got? You know, what do you need?
Yeah.
But actually, we're fortunate to be living in a time when we've got abundance of lots of things.
Yeah.
And to think about it that way round, turn it on its head, not what haven't we got, but what have we got?
And we're thinking more locally now too, aren't we? We've
very
kind of had to.
Yes.
But we've enjoyed it.
Absolutely.
So we've discovered amazing things about who's next door and down the road and what's happening in the neighbourhood.
Mm, mm. So in terms of abundance, it might be that you've got too many apples or maybe quince at this time of year. That just rot on the ground. What a waste. Or you may be somebody with time on your hands. You could maybe befriend someone who is socially isolated. That might be somebody old living on their own, or it might be a young mum sort of marooned in the house with children. Or there are all sorts of other things. You might want to have a small singing group. You might want to teach a musical instrument. We're not talking about financial transactions here.
No.
We're talking about gifting to your own local community.
Yeah.
So we're going to be asking people about that and see what comes out.
Do you know about Green Dollar?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes. We haven't gone down that route this time with Paddock Day. I should have said that it's 11 till 3 this Sunday at the Gladstone Complex. That's right next door to the Gladstone Inn.
Yes.
So it's easy to find. Entrance is gold coin.
Yeah.
Cool. So 11 till 3, it should be noisy, colourful and fun.
And what's the weather forecast?
Not great at the moment.
Isn't it? Or overcast? Windy?
I think there's a chance of rain, but but as we know in the Wairarapa, things can and do change.
Yeah, good.
So, so lots of things to do. Come and buy some stuff. It's not for charity. The stallholders will be taking home their gains.
Yeah, cool.
But we shall see.
Good, and guess who's playing in the Gladstone Inn over lunchtime till 3 o'clock?
Really?
Yeah.
Are you?
Keith and I.
Well, I think there might be one or two extra sort of
I think the Gladstone
visitors.
Will do a roaring trade with all the people coming through
to
such a wonderful venue.
Yes.
So we play on the veranda outside, and Stefan Brown usually has the gig, but he's got something else on, so he's asked us to do it.
Oh, that would be great. We'll have music on all sides.
Yeah. Good. So you also have an involvement in the community work that goes on at King Street Artworks.
Yes.
You've been involved there for a year or so now?
Yes, I think so. And that's a wonderful facility.
So don't we as doctors often miss the therapeutic value in the arts, how our patients could well benefit from an artistic experience as part of their healing, part of their therapy, their rediscovering of parts of themselves?
Absolutely, I couldn't agree more. Yeah. Medicine has got so science-based. It's taken over with medication and procedures, and we need to see health in its broadest sense, which is about well-being.
Yeah.
And we also know, as you say, the therapeutic benefits of walking outside in the open air, in the natural scenery, the blue-green effect, the calming effect of being in nature, but also the arts generally, the power of music, the power of art, of visual arts, all sorts. And King Street Artworks does provide a huge range of different types of art that people can engage in, and you see the results.
And it's good to be able to say to the few patients we have who are, you know, desperately struggling with mental health and emotional health difficulties, that there's a place they can go where they'll be welcomed and they'll be given an opportunity to explore and discover in the arts, rather than simply a counselling process, which unfortunately they run out of steam after a while, don't they? There's only so much you can talk about.
Well, they can do, and it's not the approach for everyone.
And
the thing about King Street is that there's no pressure. So you don't have to be, don't have to recognise yourself as artistic in any way. You can go and play with clay. Anyone can do that. You can produce something.
Yeah.
And you can develop a technique. You can develop skills.
Mm. And they have tutors who are there to guide you every step of the way. They meet you at the beginning and take you on a journey.
Yeah, and they are really all impressive people. I've been delighted to meet them and hear and learn what they do.
So they're doing a Monday night program now too.
Yes.
I think 5 to 7 or something, which is a little bit kind of difficult for the choir, which also rehearses on Monday nights. But we're going to find our new neighbours interesting to deal with Monday nights. And of course Saturday, it's a full on day on Saturday for people who might be working during the week, if you want to go down there.
Yeah, and it's open to anybody. That's the thing. You don't have to have a specific mental health problem.
No.
But I think the Monday night session is going to have the benefit of background concert, actually.
Yes.
Maybe you'll get some new choir members.
Yes, well, people come and go. There's a hardcore, but there's a bit of movement.
Mm.
And you're involved with the choir too, aren't you?
I've been with the Wairarapa Singers for, I think, 3 years now.
Uh-huh.
So that's our local community-based choir, and it's a large one, 80-odd members. And it's a non-auditioned choir, although recently we have done some voice matching, which was a bit challenging for some. But you can join and take part in weekly rehearsals. We're usually training for an event, and we've got our next concert. We've got two dates, 22nd and 23rd of May, which will be advertised soon, and tickets will be available from choir members, and that's called Showtime. And so this is going to be a fun concert with a lot of popular music from the shows, from all the great shows, Les Miserables, West Side Story, The Greatest Showman.
Phantom of the Opera.
Phantom of the Opera.
Cool.
So we've got a wonderful programme, so I hope people will
And where are you doing us. That?
There again, my memory is failing. I think it's at some Met school, but don't... it will all be in the advertising. I'm not sure. Escape me. It will be in the advertising. I'll give you a plug for nearer the time.
That's May, so we've got a few more MMP shows to come, so we can mention it and maybe play some of the songs. We could do a special.
You could.
You don't do recording though, do you?
We record the concerts, and then they're usually available on a CD. Afterwards. So, okay.
Well, I'll see if I can find one of your back catalogue.
Okay. Yeah. We did a cool Cole Porter one a few years ago.
Cool.
Yeah.
Well, I know people really, really enjoy the Wairarapa singers' performances and how you often work with other groups as well.
Yes.
And put on a show, a combined show with perhaps the orchestra or...
Yes. Orchestra Wellington often work with us, or we work with them. What I would say is we seem to be rather overbalanced at the moment in favour of sopranos and altos, so we need male singers, please.
Yeah.
You don't have to be able to read music, it helps of course, and you don't have to be auditioned, but any men out there that fancy joining us as tenors or basses, do come and make contact.
Good. Well, Helen, it's been delightful having you on the program. I'm sorry we haven't had the visual. The cameras didn't turn on to include you. But I assure you, Helen's looking good today, everybody. and I hope you have a very happy day, and we'll meet again soon.
Thanks to you. Same.
And good luck with Sunday. We'll be next door shooting people across there, announcing. Perhaps I'll get a program from you, and then I can tell people at the pub what's on next door. Should we do that?
I'll sort that out, certainly. Okay. Thank you.
All right, thanks for coming. Everybody, I'm going to play a song while I get myself organised. It is Colette Nicholson's birthday today. She performs under the name of Colette Rivers, and her CD is out now. It's titled Wandering Thoughts, and I'd like to play the first track of the CD. It's called... Out of the Cage.
Temple of fire, you see. unspoken. Folded fast and quickly broken. But you didn't seem to care, seem to mind. How it lingered in the air and down the line. It all started with a moment.
Colette Rivers. Happy birthday, Colette. That was Out of the Cage from her recently released EP, Wandering Thoughts. Well, to the business of MMP. Well, wasn't it nice to hear from Helen Clayson about the Paddock Day in Gladstone and the King Street Artworks program? And she's a great enthusiast for things peripheral to her profession. In the north of the Wairarapa, Paiatua, Ekitahuna, Dannevirke region, we have some information about things that are coming up. On the 14th to the 17th of April, next week, the Dannevirke High School presents Hairspray. This is a musical, so please come and support the students in this fun program. Tickets are on sale at the student office, $20 for adults, students, children, $15, family, $55. And you can contact the Dannevirke High School if you want to find out more about the program. Starts at 7 o'clock, 14th to the 17th of this month. In Dannevirke, there is going to be a level one first aid training on the 15th of April. Delwyn is the one to contact about that. It's at the St John Hall on Thyra Street in Dannevirke, 8:30 to 5 on the 15th of April. And there's also first aid with Red Cross on the 15th and 16th of April. So get in touch through Tararua Reap, 15 Gordon Street, Dannevirke, if you want to do a comprehensive or revalidation first aid course. It's great for keeping you and the team safe in the workplace. The Professionals Smallholders Auction is on the 17th of April. Just giving you a bit of a heads up of what's coming up at the end of next week. Brian Beale is organising that. The Dannevirke Showgrounds, Neptune Street in Dannevirke, 10:30 on the 17th, which will be Saturday week. And you're sure to find a bargain at this auction, which includes livestock, poultry, machinery and sundries. It sounds like they're having a kind of a modified version of the Gladstone Paddock Day, but they're calling it a smallholders auction. I hope they have some music and some food provided as well, or else they're just no competition. Don't stand a chance. All right, I would like to thank Lisa Te Moananui, who was my guest last week. She's the coordinator of the school program at the YMCA. Wish her all the best for what's coming up when the school holidays start in the near future. I could cut to another track. I've got some music by Darren Watson to play you in a short while, but I'll just keep reading out some of the interesting events that are coming up in the next week. At the Harlequin Theatre on Dixon Street in Masterton, The Princess and the Pea starts tonight, 7 o'clock, and it runs through till Sunday, the 11th, with a 4 p.m., sort of a late afternoon show. There are shows on Friday at 7 o'clock. Saturday, there are two shows, 1:30 and 6, and Sunday, 4 o'clock. It's $20 for adults, $14 for students. It's a wonderful event to take the children to, children-friendly. And if you love the story of Princess and the Pea, you will love this very funny, quirky musical play. It's for adults and students aged 6 to 16. And we're very lucky to have amazing talent, which will leave you feeling quite invigorated once you've been in their presence for the course of the play. Princess and the Pea at the Harlequin Theatre. And then at Wairarapa College, they're putting on Oliver Junior. And that starts on Wednesday, the 21st of April. So I'm giving you a heads up on this one. It's a perfect school holiday entertainment, and that will be right in the middle of the school holidays. Wednesday, the 21st, through till Friday, the 23rd, at the Wairarapa College Auditorium. I will say more about that next week. There's a special ranger program for juniors at Pukaha, which is at the Mount Bruce National Wildlife Centre. And that starts on Monday the 19th. So this is a school holiday program for juniors aged 5 to 14. Hands-on experience learning in Pukaha's nature reserve. So if you've got no plans for the week after next for your children, think of Pukaha Junior Rangers. It runs from 11 till 3:30 on the Monday through to Friday of the 19th to the 23rd. If you want to ring about that, the phone number's 06375 8004, or you can email info@pukaha.org.nz to find out more about that. So, Wairarapa Community Orchestra presents All Sorts. This is on Saturday this weekend, the 10th of April. The Wairarapa Community Orchestra welcomes you to join them at their autumn concert, All Sorts, their first at the Carterton Event Centre. Under conductor Ruth Eckford, and with members ranging in age from early teens to early 70s, the 40-piece orchestra will entertain and delight you with a programme of all sorts of music. There'll be something for everybody. And the orchestra is excited to be giving the first performance of Frog Farm Suite, a piece written for the orchestra by New Zealand composer Jonathan Birkin while he was spending an artist residency at Frog Farm in Gladstone, the home of the Wairarapa Community Orchestra bassoonist Belinda Carey. He was here in November last year, spent 3 weeks, and composed a lot of music, some of which the regional orchestra are playing on Saturday, and some of which he'll be playing personally at Coco Dessert Bar in Queen Elizabeth Park the following Friday, when we see the singer-songwriter, folk musician side of Jonathan. He's a wonderful artist. His day job is the organist at St. Andrew's Church in Lower Hutt, and he's been a feature on the musical map in Wellington for decades now. A lot of students have come through and been taken care of by him as their tutor. There's also going to be a cello concert with soloist Caitlin Morris. I said concert, I meant concerto. As part of the Wairarapa Community Orchestra program, they're featuring a cello concerto, a pre-classical composer, George Fon, who worked from 1717 to 1750. So it's pre-romantic music, pre-classical. And Caitlin Morris is the soloist. There are also other well-loved pieces being played on Saturday night by Dvorak, his Slavonic Dance No. 1, and Mussorgsky's Great Gate of Kiev. So it's a lot of music, and I'm afraid I'm telling you about now, because the next item on my agenda is Hot Club Sandwich at the Royal Hotel in Featherston. And they are doing kind of like a dinner dance, but it's a concert with a meal on Wednesday next week, the 14th of April, 6 till 8 o'clock. It's a reunion of Hot Club Sandwich, who haven't played together for a while. The original members, Andrew London, guitar and vocals, Terry Crayford, bass and keyboard, and they have someone else joining them. I'll find his name further on. So their program follows a recording process. They play swing-style 1940s music. Some of them are Terry Crayford's original songs. And they've put out 8 albums in total. They've done a live DVD of a night's performance at Wellington's old St. Paul's, and they had a residency there for about 10 years. They've headlined at jazz festivals all over New Zealand. They've played in Sydney, they've played in Norfolk Island, and they actually played a few concerts in Saudi Arabia after being hosted by the New Zealand Embassy over there. They disbanded in 2012, and they're coming together now for this dinner show at Featherston's Royal Hotel, and their special guest is James Tate Jamieson. He comes along with his saxophone, his flute, his Irish whistle, and his melodica. So he's the third member of Hot Club Sandwich for next Wednesday night. It's $50 a ticket, and you do get kind of like tapas. It's a bit more than finger food. So there's a kind of a meal and this wonderful music from one of New Zealand's iconic bands, and they're not that old yet. I think we might see quite a lot more of them. Now, the Carterton Event Centre, lots goes on there. It's a wonderful place, a wonderful venue. Of course, the library, the Carterton Library, is nearby, and the offices of the district council are nearby. But what we're concerned about is what happens in the Carterton Event Centre. And on the 16th of April, which is Friday week, there is a night of fun, games, music and food hosted by the Digital Seniors. They've titled the show, What Would You Do for a Dollar? So you bring your friends, book a table to enjoy the game show event and live music from Wairarapa's premier cover band, Audio Underground. And there'll be food from the award-winning Clareville Bakery. Tables for groups of 4 to 8. So book that. It's $40 admission. Starts at 7 o'clock Friday next week at the Carterton Event Centre. Here is a track by Darren Watson off his most recent CD, which is titled Getting Sober for the End of the World. I'm going to play you track 5, which is titled Ernie Abbott.
His casket on a gold Kingswood Ute, and the people they stood around crying. A neat little basket of beautiful flowers that I said for the dying. He didn't have much, just a dog and a bed, and he spent his whole life cleaning up rooms for the fight what we just gave away, and the many bowing down to the few. Somebody got to know who took the life of this peaceful man. To know who put Ernie Abbott's soul in God's hands. Do didn't go far to reach heaven that day. Just bent down to pick up somebody's case. A ratty old bag left behind by the door. And Ernie wasn't gone without a trace. Somebody's got to know who took the life of this peaceful man. Somebody got to know who put Ernie Abbott's soul in God's hand. In God's hand.
Ernie Abbott by Darren Watson off his album Getting Sober for the End of the World. Darren writes a soulful song as a blues master with a story to tell. And he's doing a concert this weekend over on the Kapiti Coast, which you can find out about, I'm sure, by looking in the Dominion post. Or just Googling Darren Watson and see what he's up to. Might be the Pai Kokoriki Hall that he's playing at, I'm not sure. But anyway, I know that he is out with his band and they've got some guest artists with them. So it's quite a big concert he's doing this weekend. Good luck, Darren. So more about what's happening in the Wairarapa, our gorgeous valley. Autumn changes are happening, duck shooting's around the corner, and on Sunday we have a wonderful Italian duo which are part of a quartet. So it's Flavio Villani and Marco Pop Restov. They're set to perform at Wood Street, number 57 Wood Street, 4 o'clock on Sunday, as part of Ed and Juliet Cook's classical music program, which they offer and have done for many years to the benefit of the Grey Town and the Wairarapa community. So look out for these two guys, pianist Flavio Villani, violinist Mark Poporistov. They're Italian and they're here as part of a quartet, but coming over to the Wood Street venue to play on Sunday as a duo. Just going to the events that you can all find out about in the midweek, I'd just like to highlight a couple of things. First of all, the Tin Hut has closed. As from Sunday week ago, doors closed. So the notice about the open mic night at 7:30 tonight will be redundant. It's an old notice, and whoever's organising it, I think that might be Sean, hasn't got up to date with his programming. And I hope he finds another venue to do the open mic night. There is the Featherston Music Club, which I think he also runs, and that's on Monday from 7 till 9 at the Featherston Community Centre. A slightly different orientation to that evening than an open mic night. But if you want to find out what Sean's up to, give him a call on 027 672 6249. So the Salvation Army, Oasis, have a free counselling service to help people with gambling and addiction problems. That meets at 41 Perry Street in Masterton, the Salvation Army Oasis. And there's a phone number to call to talk to Ramil. 370-3317 or the cell phone 021-804-339. If you have concerns about your gambling habits or other addictions and want some help and some support, or maybe you know someone who could be referred to the Salvation Army Oasis. Age Concern have a program to prevent falls titled Steady As You Go. It's a falls prevention class, and that's on Thursday this morning, 9:30. So on your bike, you've got an hour to get there. Senior Citizens Hall in Cole Street. And I would encourage you folk who are over 75-ish, especially if you've had injuries that are catching up with you, or you're developing arthritis or fibromyalgia that slows you down and makes you a bit unsteady on your feet. Learning how to prevent falls by strengthening muscles is a very good investment. Narcotics Anonymous meet tonight, 7:30 to 8:30 at the St. Matthew's Church on Church Street. I think it's in the hall beside the church, actually. 7:30 to 8:30 if you want to have some support from Narcotics Anonymous or learn about the effects narcotics have and dependency that results. Going on to Friday, Aratoi, the art gallery in the north of our town, Masterton, is having a combined opening at 5:30 on Friday for you and yours. Recent acquisitions is the program going till May the 9th. Jason Burns has his first solo exhibition, 1:50 to May the 9th. That's his exhibition, 1:50. Helene Carroll's Imperfect Offerings show is on till June the 13th. And Park Up Photographs by Catherine Russ are on until June the 20th. So all of those shows are opening tomorrow night at 5:30 at Aratoi, and you're welcome to go along, meet the artists, and be impressed by their work. The Masterton Variety Club meets on Friday for a practice, 10 in the morning until midday at 10 Albert Street. New members are welcome. The Variety Club, amateur theatre, possibly some singing, dancing. Not quite sure what they do, but Eric McEwen on 377-0792 or Doreen Wakefield at 370-4606 will be able to tell you what goes on at the Masterton Variety Club. On Saturday in Martinborough, leaving from the town hall at 4 o'clock, there is the Labyrinth Walk, facilitated by the First Church in Martinborough. So it looks like a four-hour walk, starting at 4 o'clock in the afternoon, titled Labyrinth Walk. And there's no phone number to ring. I think you just have to turn up, have faith, and enjoy. Also on Saturday, don't forget, Saturday is Toy Library Day, as most days are during the week, probably not Sundays, but on Saturday, the Toy Library in Masterton is open from 10 till 1 at 365 Queen Street. And in Featherston, also 10 till midday at 14 Wakefield Street. And Abby Waterson on 021-0256-6719 is the person who organises the Toy Library in Featherston. No contact for the Toy Library in Masterton, which is at 365 Queen Street. Saturday, I've already mentioned to you about the Wairarapa Community Orchestra playing at the Carterton Event Centre Saturday night. Don't forget that. And of course, there's the Farmers Market at the Solway Showgrounds on Saturday. On Sunday, the Aratoi Wairarapa Museum of Art and History will have Helena Carroll hosting an artist's talk at 11 o'clock. So the exhibition opened on Friday at 5:30. Helene would have been there, and she's giving a talk on Sunday at 11 o'clock in the morning on her exhibition titled Imperfect Offerings. Y Word are back on the map for their monthly meeting on Sunday the 11th. A behind-the-scenes look at book publishing and selling. It's at the Carterton Event Centre, 50 Holloway Street, starts at 3 o'clock. Y Word. So if you're interested in the written word, prose, epics, factual stories, or poetry even, it all comes under the umbrella of Y Word. And I would encourage you to check them out. 3 o'clock on Sunday afternoon at the Carterton Event Centre. I've mentioned the Featherston Music Club run by Sean on Monday, 7 till 8 till 9 p.m. at the Featherston Community Centre. So just to give another plug for that. And going on to the next page, listeners, we have many more interesting events to tell you about. And I'm very soon going to click on to another song because it's nice to punctuate what I have to say with a song. In fact, we're going to go right now to the Beatles playing Nowhere Man.
A man sitting in his nowhere land, making all his nowhere plans for now. Isn't he a bit like you and me? Nowhere man, please listen. You don't know what you're missing. Nowhere man, the world is at your command.
Nowhere man.
The Beatles, Nowhere Man, off the remastered Rubber Soul. I first heard that when I was about 15. Probably learnt the words within the first 3 months. Added them to the repertoire of cool songs that we could sing, kind of. We never worked out George's the exact chord patterns he was using, but they're pretty cool. So we're getting to the end of our show, everybody, for Thursday. Move, Mingle and Play has to move on. But I will tell you, just the next 2 days into next week, we've done some of what's happening on Monday. On Tuesday, April the 13th, we've got Parkinson's hydrotherapy class at the Rec Centre Pool in Masterton. $3.60 entry fee. Jane Flower Day runs that. 10:30 on Tuesday at the Rec Centre Pool if you want to take part in the Parkinson's hydrotherapy class. And Parkinson's is a very debilitating illness, but folk who have it learn very quickly how to live with it, and exercise is very much a part of maintaining the function they have, and helping them to continue participating in activities. Also on Tuesday, the Martinborough Community Choir meets at the First Church Hall in Weld Street, Martinborough. 7:15 to 9 o'clock. Vicky Jones is the conductor, leader of the Martinborough Choir, and I'd encourage any of you singers, even if you're a closet singer, but you'd like to be in a choir, they're very approachable and the standard of their music is high but not unreachable. Masterton Alcoholics Anonymous meet on Tuesday at 7:30 p.m. at the St. Matthew's Church Hall, 35 Church Street. It's a wonderful group, I'm sure, and very supportive of people struggling with alcoholism. Best thing is to own up to it and get along there and get help, and your life can be a lot better and the people in your life can be a lot happier. So call Anne 378-2338 or David 021-116-5505 if you want more information about Alcoholics Anonymous in Masterton meeting on Tuesday night. Time for one more. Going to Wednesday, the Rock and Roll Dance Class, 7:30 to 8:30, is held. Golly, they don't even say where it is. That might be at the Dance Shed venue in Carterton. I think it is. It's because it's underneath that bit of information. But you can call Wendy if you want to learn about rock and roll and take part. You want some coaching as a couple. You might even want to get competitive. Wendy is on 027-319-9814. And the final mention for today is the Silver Ukulele Club in Featherston, my favourite ukulele players. They meet on Wednesday, 1 to 3pm at the Featherston Community Centre. Jan is the leader of that group, organiser. 06-308-8556. Well, we've come to the end of the show. We're 1 minute to spare. Have a wonderful day and have a wonderful weekend. Get around some of those events that I've mentioned. We'll catch you next week.